Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a super fun video. I'm going to be opening up a comic book mystery grab bag. So I purchased it from mycomicshop.com and I'm going to be opening it up, and I haven't seen any of it, so it's like a surprise to me as much as it is to you. Before I get into that, I just want to show you guys this jacket I got because it's related to comic books in a way. Anyway, but let me just show you because it got here at the same time. It's this super cute Spider-Woman jacket. Well, it's the original Spider-Woman anyway. Jessica Drew. And yeah, I love it. I'm obsessed with it. I got it from her universe. And I just want to show you guys because I got that at the same time as my comic books. So yeah. Anyway, my comic books are still completely, all I did was open the box. I have not seen any of them or anything like that. Now, the actual grab bag itself, they had different categories. I was going to get a Marvel one, and maybe I'll get one in the future and do another video, but I opted for a Spider-Man one because I knew for sure I would like all the comics, or most likely anyway. It did retail for $17. However, with shipping and tax, and there's like an additional tax because mycomicshop.com is also Lone Star Comics, which is located in Texas, so they give you an extra Texas sales tax if you live in Texas like I do. So anyway, that's how that came out to like $24, but it was still a great price because it said that there was 2 pounds of comics and that it was either like between 25 and 40 comics, just depends on you know, the thickness of each comic. And so if you think about it, even if each one is only a dollar, which most likely that's not true, you still get your money's worth. So it did come, you know, with paper protective, which is great because you wouldn't want to be like messed up. Yeah, Spider-Man value pack grab bag, 25 to 40 comics, and no duplicates. So that's another good thing. You don't want two of the same comics. Another great thing is in each of the corners of the grab bag, there is one of these little foam corner protectors, which is great because you don't want bent corners. And here we go. Look at that. Let's get right into this. Now, before I begin, I'd like to mention I am clearly not an expert in comic books. I collect them. I love reading them. I know about a lot of them. But when it comes to knowing their value or anything like that, you know, that's not my specialty. But I just wanted to check these out, see what I get, and kind of see, you know, what's in here and if it's worth it, you know, even though maybe monetarily speaking it would be worth it because, like I said, even if each one's only a dollar, you get your money's worth. But maybe, like, let's see if it's worth it from a comic book fan's perspective and whatnot. So these are all quite old, as you can tell. You can just see by the colors of the pages, because now the pages look white. So let's just get started. We've got The Amazing Spider-Man number 51. And I think it looks like Mary Jane on the cover. So that's that one. Put a little space here for me to put these. Then we have Web of Spider-Man, and it's number 78. It's the final showdown with Firebrand, and yeah, that's that. That one looks pretty cool. We have another Web of Spider-Man. Wait, was that one of Web? Yeah, it was. This one is number 120. It's got Scarlet Spider. I do have another Scarlet Spider comic. This one looks pretty interesting as well. And, oh, that's weird. Hold on. Okay. Oh, it like flips over. I don't know if you see that. So it's like here and here. I've not really seen another comic like that. That's pretty interesting. We have another Web of Spider-Man. This one is number 29. So kind of random numbers. Like they're not like consistent, but that's okay. And this is side-by-side with X-Men's Wolverine. This one looks pretty cool. We see Venom there and Wolverine and whatnot. That's a cool one. We've got Spider-Man Slip Sliding Away. This is number... Why don't I see the number? That's weird. I don't see it. It says Marvel 25th anniversary. This one looks kind of interesting too. We've got another Web of Spider-Man. Seems like a common one in here. I would assume, now I can't say this for certain because, like I said, I'm not the expert on value of comic books, but I would assume that maybe Web of Spider-Man is maybe not a super popular series or not a super valuable one, and that's why it's in here. It looks like it was originally $1, and it does show from 1988 here. So this was number 40 though. And that's that. Wow, great job dropping it. I try to protect my comic books so much, and then something like that happens. Anyway, we have Peter Parker, Spectacular Spider-Man. Hold on, I just realized the tape is going to start sticking to them. Let me fold that down. This is number 111, and this is a crossover with the Secret Wars, too. So that's interesting. And then there's an ad for Secret Wars, too, back there. We've got another Marvel 25th anniversary. This is the all new, all daring Peter Parker, the Spectacular Spider-Man, number 119, Sabretooth's back, it says. Okay. We've got a Peter Parker, the Spectacular Spider-Man, number 48. I kind of love the artwork on some of these. It's very classic. Sometimes what the artwork on some of the comics today is very new, not, you know. So you don't really get that classic artwork as much. Then we have the Spectacular Spider-Man number 158, and it says, now the strongest hero in the Marvel Universe. So I'm curious what the story is there. And I'll definitely read all of these. It probably will take me a while, especially because I'm gonna read the weekly comics at the same time, but eventually, I'll read all of them. This is the Spectacular Spider-Man number 149. If Gwen Stacy wasn't a clone, it says. Interesting. We have the Amazing Spider-Man number 256. And that's what that one looks like. I wish I had more to say about some of these, but I really would need to read the stories, kind of research them, but I'll definitely do that, and maybe I'll do a follow-up video or mention in another video. We have The Amazing Spider-Man number 395, and this says it's from 1994, so we had some from the 80s, now these are getting into the 90s, just worth noting. And then we have The Amazing Spider-Man number 373. And inside there's a great new tale of Venom. It also says now on sale twice a month. So I'm not sure if they're saying that this particular comic, The Amazing Spider-Man, would come out twice a month, like two new issues a month, or if they're saying that reprints. But either way, that's quite interesting based on how comics are released now. They're almost, you know, more frequently, I would say. So that's that. Also, can we look at this candy in the back? Is this the one? This was from 1992, and look at this candy. The ads now are for the video games or whatever. This is just some good old candy. Can't argue with that. We have The Amazing Spider-Man number 232, featuring the most savage supervillain of all. There's that one. We have a giant-sized 350th issue, The Amazing Spider-Man, Spidey versus Doctor Doom, and obviously this is number 350. Plus, Spidey's reunion with Uncle Ben. What it says? Yeah, this one actually looks really good. Although I find it super funny how they're giant-sized 350th issue. If you saw recently Spider-Man 800 or yeah 800, that one was huge. So this is nothing compared to that, but you know, it was the time, and that's cool. This is The Amazing Spider-Man number 352, guest starring Nova of the New Warriors. And this says, okay, well that's quite random on a Spider-Man comic, but 50 years of Captain America. So this was 1991. Yeah. A lot of these are from the 90s or some of them from the 80s. Now, if we go over here, they're kind of flipped around, so they're all facing the back now. So let me just move that out of the way. We've got, this is Spider-Man number 65, I believe it is. This is a part 3 of 3. I don't quite see a year on here, but this one does look a little more modern, just like the artwork in general, and even the pages. Let me see if I can find a year. Should be somewhere. Here we go. I think it's from the 80s. I'm seeing like 1985. Could be wrong, but yeah, it looks more modern. It looks a little more like the comics we see today. We also have The Return of Spider-Man, and then we have Her Name is Poison, which I would assume is the first appearance of. Again, this looks like a little bit more modern artwork, which I could be wrong on that, because the other one was, I believe, from the 80s. Let's see. This is 1996, so yeah, this is getting a little more modern. Still before I was even born, but okay, I know this one is going to be more modern because we have Spider-Man 2 The Game and ad in the back for it. Ooh, this one looks so good. Venom Carnage number 3. Look at that. Oh, that looks so good. Okay, we have Brand New Day, The Amazing Spider-Man number 555. Again, looks a little more modern. Let me see if I can find a year. I won't do that for all of them, but I just was curious. 2008. So yeah, we're getting like into the early 2000s. So we kind of went from 80s to 90s. Now we're getting into the 2000s. Interesting. This one was from Free Comic Book Day, which for those of you who are comic book fans and maybe are new to collecting, Free Comic Book Day is the first weekend or the first Saturday in May every year. So you can go to several local comic book stores, maybe not all of them, but most of them, and you can get free comic books. So this is Marvel Age Spider-Man. I think this is a number 1. Funny enough, though, it says, not for resale. Technically, this was a resale since I bought this, but okay. And originally, it was from Austin Books and Comics. I wonder if they still exist. I mean, I'm sure they do, because this was, like, pretty recent. Or not recent, but it wasn't so long ago either. Anyway, moving on. We have The Superior Spider-Man, Goblin Nation Part 2. This is number 28. And I know this one has got to be very recent, because it has the digital edition, which is something on a lot of the recent comics. So let me see a year on this one. Even though I said I'm not going to do that for all of them. Yeah, 2014. So definitely recent. I like this one. This one looks good too. This is Venom. And this is Run Part 2, number 7. That looks actually pretty cool. I'm a big Venom fan, so I'm kind of biased in that sense. Ooh, this one looks kind of... I like the cover art on this one. Brand New Day, The Amazing Spider-Man, number 548. And just like the other one said, now on sale 2 times a month, this one says now on sale 3 times a month. So you can definitely see where they've become, like, more frequent. Okay, this is from 2004. I already saw that. This is Ultimate Spider-Man Carnage Part 5, and this is issue number 64. Look at that. That looks like a good one, too. Moving on. We've got an Ultimate Spider-Man issue. Wait, what? Hold up. Oh, okay. So we have issue number 62, and this is Carnage Part 3. So we had Part 3, Part 5. Looks like a cool series. So if it is a cool series, I'll definitely have to find the rest of them. We have Friendly Neighborhood Spider-Man number 5. This one looks modern, but it also looks like, I don't know, it looks interesting to me. 2006. So this looks like something good. This looks like a good read. Like, it looks like good. We have Infinity Superior Spider-Man Team Up number 4. This one also has the digital edition. Well, it had at the time because they're usually only for like a year. So that's got to be more modern, but I won't check the year because I know, it's getting annoying. But no, we've got Thanos on the cover. Yeah. I don't know, I was trying to think of something clever to say, like Thanos, Spider-Man snapped, but yeah, I couldn't think of a joke fast enough. This one looks classic. We have a Marvel Tales starring Spider-Man number 153. Look at this. Ooh, I love it. Another classic Marvel milestone by Stan Lee and Steve Ditko, it says. May they rest in peace, both of them, who passed away last year. This one looks great. Very classic artwork. 1984. And actually, it has an offer for a Kool-Aid Man comic book for free. Unfortunately, the offer expired March 31st, 1984. So, yeah, I can't get that. Anyway, moving on, we've got The Amazing Spider-Man Chaos in Calgary, number 4. Again, it looks very classic. I would venture to say it's from the 80s, probably. Yeah, this one looks pretty cool, too. I'm almost done here, guys. I should have been counting how many there are so that I could have told you guys, because they did say between 25 and 40. But when I'm done showing you all of them, I'll pause the video, count them, come back, and let you guys know. We've got a The Amazing Spider-Man Hit and Run number 3. This one is another good-looking one. Looks interesting. Let's see. We've got The Amazing Spider-Man Double Trouble number 2. I'm confused on the year. Like, I'm getting, like, let me just see. 1992. Okay, I was like, there's a Nintendo ad in the back, so maybe it's not too old, but the artwork looks very classic. But, okay, so there's that. And then we have The Amazing Spider-Man Skating on Thin Ice number 1. Why did I recently see this one? I recently saw this one. I don't know where. But I recently saw this one, and I think it's interesting. So I'll definitely have to check that out. Almost done, guys. We've got like 4 more left. We've got Marvel Select Spider-Man number 1, The Spider or the Man? ? It says. The wildest shock ending of all time. Got that. That looks a little more modern. It doesn't have a digital edition, so maybe it's not super modern, but I would say 2000s. We've got, this one's interesting. So the way it feels very thick right here, and then on this side it feels kind of thinner. That's quite it. Oh, you know what it is? Yeah, I knew there was something in the middle. Yeah. All new artwork, blah, blah, blah. Okay, yeah, I was like, there's something over here that's making it feel hard. Anyway, this is the new Spider-Man 2099, number 19. Ooh, I need to read this. Spider-Man 29. Miguel O'Hara, but I don't know if this is the same one since it said the new, but yes, I'm a fan. I stan. This one is, I love this one. Wait, do I have this one? Or did I read it? I know I read it, but do I have this one? I have the, okay, I'll tell you guys right now. This is the annual Web of Spider-Man Part 3, The Vibranium Vendetta. And you've got Black Panther, you got Iron Man, you got Spider-Man all in the cover. I think I have part 1 of this one, either part 1 or part 2, not part 3. So I'll have to get whichever one I don't have so I can have a full collection of that one. And we've reached the last one. We have Web Spinners, Tales of Spider-Man, First Spectacular Issue, and this one was from exactly 6 months before I was born, January 1999. So that's pretty cool. Very interesting artwork on here. So definitely, well, I'll check them all out. I'll read them all, of course. But yeah, that concludes the unboxing. I'm gonna quickly kind of go off camera, count them, and I'll let you know how many I got. So I just finished counting, and there was 37 in total. So 38, 39, 40, sorry. I could not do math in my head right now. I'm so tired. But I was three away from the most that they would send you, which is pretty cool in my opinion. Definitely, definitely think I got my money's worth. There was several in there that I'm like, I want to read these as soon as possible. There was a lot that I'm like, okay, I can read those whenever I get a chance. But there was a lot, there was several in there that I really want to read as soon as possible. So I really think I did get my money's worth. Obviously a grab bag, you're not going to expect, a super rare comic or something unless you're like super lucky. But I like what I got. I think there's a great variety of more modern comics as well as more classic comics. There's a good range of years. We've got from like early 80s all the way to like more recent to like I think 2014. So, I'm pretty impressed with this. I think I will definitely be ordering that Marvel one very soon to see what Marvel comics they would send me. And, like I said, very impressed by it. Really want to read all of them. I think it was very much worth it. So, yeah, that is that. And make sure you like this video. Comment down below which is your favorite Spider-Verse character. So if you've seen the movie Spider-Verse, it can be any of those, Miles, Penny, Gwen, Noir, original Peter Parker. And it can be any of them. Or if you're a comic book fan, you can let me know. Maybe you have a different Spider-Verse character that's your favorite. So let me know in the comments down below. And I'll tell you guys my favorite. Ooh, I have several. Silk, Spider-Gwen, May Parker, obviously original Earth, the original Peter Parker, I always forget what Earth, I know it's the same one, but the, like, more recent Miles Morales comics, big fan of those, so just let me know which is your favorite, comment that down below, like this video, I think I already said that, but just go like it if you haven't already, and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you'll be notified every time I post a video. I have a very special, the video itself is not special, but something happening in the video, something I'm unveiling is special, so that'll be coming out very soon, so be on the lookout for that, and yeah, thanks for watching, bye.